very good day to you and a very Merry Christmas from myself, Chairman of Governors, Robin Southwell, all the governors, the head, the senior leadership team, and in fact the entire staff and support community of Parkside. And gosh, what a year it's been for us all. Now is a good time for us to reflect on the last 12 months. And myself, I was thinking, what was I doing this time last year? Well, I was contemplating buying a new car. I was thinking about the parties that I was going to have and the summer holidays that I was going to enjoy. And those were very important to me at the time. And then, well, we all know what happened. We had COVID and the crisis and the challenge which affected our nation, our world, our community, and of course, our Parkside. And as we think about what that meant for our school and the challenges that we all had to assume as we went forward into this dark, difficult new tunnel. And I look at Parkside and I realise that in this time, we were not found wanting. And when I say we, I really do mean you. I look at the teachers who, in a matter of days, had to completely change their ways of work and how they administered their teaching and learning to your children and our pupils. I look at how you as parents had to share with us the joy of education, the partnership of making sure our children continued to soak up their knowledge and enjoy their subjects. And thirdly, and perhaps most importantly, I look at the way the pupils, you didn't sit back and feel sorry for yourself. Clearly you're upset in not being able to meet your friends and enjoy the wider school community. But you knuckled down and working with your parents, working with the school, we got through and we continue to enable you to enjoy the academic side of this school, even though the pastoral and wider social side was not so obviously there for you. And then we saw, as summer moved forward, things that mattered to us in the past didn't matter to us in their then future. For example, for me, I enjoyed the company of my family. I enjoyed making meals and sitting round a table and conversing rather than having a hurried snack in front of the TV. And things that in the past we didn't think of so much, such as the value of our community, of our frontline staff clapping hands for all of the efforts that people were putting in to ensuring our nation, our community, our poor and our unhealthy were getting through this time. And these started to come forward as the things that mattered in our society. And we changed and we stood up to the challenge. And we as a community, we as a school, we as a nation really started to understand compassion, became humbled, and we were at war. And it wasn't a war like the Iran-Iraq war where we sent troops out to fight on the front line in a far-off country. Every single one of us was on the front line fighting an enemy called COVID that we couldn't see and that was proving very difficult to hold down. But it's amazing how each and every one of us, and I must focus here on you, our pupils, how you became frontline warriors, supporting your families, embracing the challenge, working for the school, and all credit to you in what you have achieved. Because you have come out of this stronger, better. And I say that very clearly aware that there have been people in our community that have not come through. And this is the time at Christmas to remember those that didn't last the journey, that had untimely departures from us, or to this day are suffering from long COVID, and still do. And my hearts and our thoughts go out to all members of our community and their families that were affected from them. But we are where we are today, and it's a tribute to you that we have managed to break through and get to this stage of this journey. So what does it mean today now, as I look back on these last 12 months? Well, the things that mattered to me then, clearly now, do not. What matters is friendships, family, my faith, and yes, our future. And when I say our faith, we remember at this time, in the Christian church, that God gave his son for our faith and our future. And those values of care, compassionate giving, generosity, I'm sure are shared in the kaleidoscope of religions that form the backbone of our community and our society here. And so, we have that faith which has been developed over these last 12 months with a robustness and an integrity which has been drawn from the experience we have. And that faith will see us through. It will see us through into a future where we will have vaccines, where we will persevere. And so at this point of time in Christmas, we have that hope. We have our faith. We are better for what we have gone through. And I offer to you a bright 2021. And I offer, on behalf of all of Parkside, a very Merry Christmas. Gosh, you do deserve it. And a Happy New Year. And lots of love to you all from now on to the future from us here at Parkside. And Merry Christmas.